This is part one on how to make a global barrel, and I'm going to show you two different ways to make them. This one is just basically going to be a layout video. I'm going to show you how I did them last year and what I did wrong and what I'm going to change and how I'm going to do them this year. First thing to do is find the seam in the barrel, and you can do that by going to the top, and you can see it going right through the bung holes. We'll draw a black line on it here so you can see it better. We've got the seam highlighted from the top of the barrel down to the top edge of the first rib, just so you can see what we're doing. And eventually, that line that she's drawing along the top edge of the rib, eventually we're going to cut the whole top third of the barrel off following that top edge of the rib. But for right now, these lines are just for measuring. Measure up from the top edge of the rib 4.5 inches on the seam and put a mark. And then the next thing I did last year was I took a 3-inch hole saw and I cut a hole, and then I drew 2 straight lines down and cut that area out. That's what this drawing is here. You see the squiggly black lines? That's the area I cut out last year. The problem with doing this is when you slide the upper section into the lower section later on, these two corners here are going to squeeze together towards each other. And if you're putting this together to be used with the automatic watering system, sometimes you have a hard time getting them around the fittings for the automatic watering system. So instead, don't cut the sides straight up and down. Flare them out like this. That black line on the lower part of the barrel is the highlighted seam. And this part you only have to do if you're going to be using it with the automatic watering system. And what we're going to do is measure up 4 inches from the floor and put a mark. And later on, that's where you'll drill your hole to connect the watering system to. Right now, we're just going to mark it. We're not drilling the hole. Now, all the marks we've just done, you do exactly the same on the seam on the opposite side of the barrel. And then you draw some couple 5-inch lines, spaced, kind of divide the area between the two seams into thirds. So she turned the barrel clockwise and put a mark. And then she turned it a little more clockwise and put another mark. And now she's going to spin the barrel counterclockwise. Go about a third of the way, put a mark, and go another third of the way and put a mark. And we're just going to cut 4 5-inch long slits. Two of them between each seam. And that's just so we can make it easier to squeeze the top together when we slide it into the bottom part of the global barrel. The next thing to do is take a bucket, center it on the top of the barrel, and trace around the bottom edge, and then cut that circle out so the bucket will slide down into the hole nice and evenly. This happens to be a 4-gallon bucket, and it works great. If you've got a 5-gallon bucket and that's all you can get, that's okay too. You just it might stick up into the dirt area of your global barrel too much. You might have to trim a couple inches off the top of it. But that's 4-gallon, 5-gallon. 4 gallons work pretty good. And you also drill a whole bunch of holes in the bottom of the bucket. 1/8, 3/16, 1/4 inch, doesn't really matter. I usually do 3/16. Drill a whole bunch of them in the bottom of that bucket. Now you need to remove the lip from around the outside edge of the top of the barrel. It has to come off because it stops the top portion of the barrel from sliding into the lower half. 99% of the barrels out there, you have to remove it. There are some that you don't, but they're few and far between. To remove the lip, drill a hole through it on an angle like this, big enough to fit a jigsaw blade through. Then cut it off with the jigsaw. And keep your jigsaw in a bit of an angle like this. And you end up with a ring like this, and now that top piece of barrel will slide into the lower part of the barrel. And we made 8 of them like this last year, and it finally dawned on me, why don't I just flip the barrel upside down and cut the bottom third off, and now you don't have to remove the lip at all. And that's the way we're going to make them this year. So here it is all laid out like we just showed you, except the barrel's upside down. In part two, we'll show you how to cut it up and fit it all together. I hope this helped you out. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. God bless. Bye.